All right, so now we are at the Kali Linux that is already installed over the VirtualBox. This is running actually live, so this is not installed. There is no need to install it for the demonstration. We can use it for live, and of course I have downloaded the live version of the Kali Linux. So in order to understand the passwords mechanisms, where it is stored inside the Linux operating systems, so I'm going to use the Kali Linux here, because the all the mechanisms are same, and we can use that to understand where it is located, where it is stored. So by default, Kali Linux doesn't have the root privilege provided. We need to provide that, but I'm not going to provide root privileges for the user Kali in this case, but instead I'm going to use the sudo, that is the superdoer, or the simply say super user doer. So there are the passwords places of the Linux operating systems where all the passwords and the users informations are placed and stored in encrypted form. So let me show you using the sudo command, sudo cat etc passwd. So this is the location of the user's information. Remember, this is not the password file, this is the user's information, because the passwords are stored in another file we will see later here. Hit enter and we can see the username, the last is the Kali here, having the user ID. This, you can see the X here that says the passwords are stored and encrypted. Other informations, that the user ID is the 1000. There is the group ID that is also the 1000. This is the user Kali live user, and this is the home directory of the user Kali, and this is the shell path. So this is the location of the shell access. So that's the location of the user's information, all holds inside the etc passwd. There is no passwords contained in this file. Let's check for the passwords where it is stored. So the command is shadow, complete command is sudo cat etc shadow. So this is the command to view the password that is also encrypted. In this case, we can't see the plain text, because obviously the Linux is the secured operating systems. Here we can see the last one is the username, that is the Kali, and the encrypted password in this case is here. So in order to crack the Linux passwords, what all we need are the passwd file and the shadow file. Both files are requirement of the password cracking of Linux user or the Linux user accounts. So that's why whenever we will go for the password cracking for the Linux user, we will dump both of the files, that is the passwd file and the shadow file. And these are the locations of the user's information and the passwords. We will talk more about these settings, these options, these places, and the password cracking of the Linux accounts whenever we will go for cracking in practical. That will be in the next module. Till then, just explore these locations, try to understand every user. If you are already aware about the Linux architectures, Linux users management, Linux passwords management, that will be advantages for you to understand it easily and start the cracking right away. So that's all for this lesson. See you in the next lessons.